This strange expression appeared in our equation for heat conduction along a wire. Now we look into its mathematical meaning. A scary name for this topic is central difference formulas for derivatives. This is about determining the derivative, that means the slope of the tangent, of functions that are based on empirical data, measurements. A naive approach to determine the slope of this function at this point would be to look a little further to the right, determine another point of that function there, and then connect this point to our original point. And you can see that this does not really work well when we want to determine the derivative of our function, namely the slope of the tangent. A simple trick is to go a little to the left and a little to the right, determine the points of the function left and right, and then connect these. Typically, this works far better. Now we can write down some equations. Let's delta x stand for the total distance from left to right, delta always denoting a difference. The estimate for the slope would be what we gain in height divided by how far we went to the right. The denominator is simple. Delta x is how far we went to the right. The numerator is a little more complex. It's the difference of this value of the function minus that value of the function. That's what we are gaining in height. So it's our function on the right-hand side, f of x0 plus delta x half. From x0, we're moving by half of this distance to the right plus delta x over 2 minus the value of the function on the left-hand side, f1 x0 minus delta x over 2. We're going to the left by half of that distance minus. Now you can get an idea about why this is called central difference. Obviously, it's a difference, and the difference is centered at x0. We are moving as much to the right as we are moving to the left. Now we are going to apply the same formula to the second derivative, the rate of change of the rate of change. Think acceleration. We simply use this formula not for the original function, but for its derivative. You replace f by f prime wherever you find an f. So this f becomes an f prime, this f becomes an f prime, and this f becomes an f prime prime, the second derivative. But now we can use our original formula for these derivatives. This is going to get a little long. When estimating this first derivative, we get an expression with denominator delta x, and in the numerator we've got the following. We're moving to the right by delta x half, so we're ending with f of x0 plus delta x. We're moving one further delta f half to the right, minus we're moving delta x half to the left, which means this is f of x0. And now for this derivative. We're moving by delta x half to the right, minus delta x half plus the same cancels, so this becomes f of x0. Minus, now we have to move by delta x half to the left, which becomes x0 minus delta x divided by delta x. Let's now collect what we have found. In total, we're dividing by delta x squared. And in the numerator, we've got plus the value one step to the left, plus the value one step to the right, minus twice the value at our original position. So what originally appeared in our equation, t7 plus t9 minus 2 times t8, is 1 millimeter squared times the second derivative of the distribution of the temperature.